on my way to Master Prestige, I told people that I would make a overall class video of the best classes available in the game once I reached it, and I never really got around to it. And to be fair, there's been a lot of buffs and nerfs to the FG, some to the bar, some to the M1 Grand for no fucking reason. You know, there's some out there. But I decided I would make the video to let you guys know the five best classes in the game. If you only have five slots, if you're just starting out, you don't prestige, whatever, you're early on in their prestiges, the five best classes for S&D in the game. I say for S&D because that's mainly what I play. It's what I care about. They're really good in other game modes, but I'd probably tweak them here and there depending on the game what I play. For example, if I'm playing like War, I know I run different stuff all the time in War. But here you are, okay? Five best classes. There are my stats right now. You can see below. We have, starting off, the Airborne Rush class. PPSH is the best SMG in the game without any question. The MP40 and the Thompson are a little bit better now, but don't really equal the PPSH's ease of use. Like, you could just use this gun, straight vertical recoil. I don't even use grip because you don't need it. Straight vertical recoil when you use quick draw and advanced rifling to extend the four-shot range. That's mainly what you do. Airborne, level 4, so you can rush quicker, climb over obstacles faster, and you have a longer sprint distance. Inconspicuous for dead silence helps out, especially because recently they nerfed the sound of your footsteps. Inconspicuous helps even more, so it's even harder to hear people now. It used to be pretty easy, actually. Like, if they were within maybe 5 to 6, 7 feet and they were sprinting, very easy to hear. Now, if you have inconspicuous and you're sprinting near people, it's kind of difficult. If you're walking, you're dead silent completely. Using the auto machine pistol, whatever, it's still the best pistol in the game, even after the nerf, it's okay. You can use other pistols if you want. I just tend to lean to this one if I'm trying. The 9mm SAP is actually a really good alternative. So if you have a decent trigger finger and you can use that, pretty good option as well. Just a heads up. It's got a much better 3-shot than the machine pistol. And, I think the machine pistol is now a 4-shot everywhere. So it's better overall close range. It does shoot a little bit slower, but it has a much better recoil control, easier to use. Still good. Frag grenade in every class, pretty much. Just a heads up. Secondly, infantry. And this is specific in order here. You need this in order. I'll show you why in a second. Infantry hunker. Now, this is a class that you can be heard on, but it's more of the aggressive hold a position. You have height advantage. You have head glitches. They can't knock you off because you have hunker on now. Using a bar, grip, extended, and rapid fire. Now, I want to also say this ahead of time. I have infantry level 4 on this, but you can use other guns with these classes and still have fun and do okay, do well. Like an STG or the new Volk. You don't have to use the bar. I'm making this video because it's the best classes. This is the shit that kills me all day long, and I fucking hate it, but these are the best. If you're really trying, these are the fucking best. These are what you go to. Infantry level 4 because you get the bayonet. You can also use mountain and then use, what was it? It's not, what is it called? It's, God, mountain plus shoot. What lets you strafe decently quick? Scoped? Well, aiming down sights have less idle sway. Yeah, scoped. But it's not as good in my opinion. Mountain is full dead silence, but because of the footstep nerf, you're not really going for full dead silence anyway on this class. I'll show you one in a minute that we have it on. The footstep nerf isn't, it helps it out a little bit. This is mainly infantry because you get the bayonet with it, so close range is helpful if you want to stab someone. Extra mag, move way faster while aiming down sight. That's the main thing you want, right? And then hunker to survive grenades that are going to be spammed at you. If you're on head glitches, you have a height advantage, you have a position advantage. The only real way to beat them is by grenading them, and you can't be killed with the hunker on. So that's the main point of this. You have it in order here because when you're using this class, you'll use the airborne, you rush up really quick sometimes to get to the point that you want to head glitch or you're going to be sitting, and then you weapon swap really quick to the infantry class. I've shown examples of this before. I do it on stream all the time. I don't have a clip to give you offhand, I'm sorry. But a weapon swap is basically where you use this class. Let's say you're running really quick, and then you switch down and you go to the next class by pausing, hitting options, going down one, clicking X, and you're able to swap to the next one really quickly. And that lets you push up further on the map while having a gun that normally couldn't rush or push that far. You can't weapon swap in every Call of Duty game, but you can in this one, so take advantage of it. You have 15 seconds to do it in normal games. Usually you only have to do it up to like 10 seconds. So, third class is your infantry inconspicuous. This is your one that has your strafe speed, your bayonet, but also the dead silence if you have sound horrors. This is more the class that you want to move up with, not one that you're holding in position, okay? This is the one where you push through and you flank. This is not a flanking class. You get sound horrored. This is a flanking class. So you can flank with this one if you want to. A lot of the times I don't end up flanking with rifles, but some people do. I like the SMGs more for that, but that's just me. Same class, just inconspicuous instead. Fourth class is your sniper. A sniper is very useful on certain maps in this game. One of them is like the Gustav Cannon, and another is the USS Texas. A lot of sniper spots, we'll say. Mountain Division, so you can hold your breath, also because you're always invisible to enemy aircraft and silent movement. The aircraft thing is not as big in search, but it can help here and there. The silent movement's really helpful, obviously. I use Lookout personally. Some people, a lot of people, like to use Rifleman, and then they just dick ride the fucking PPSH like this. I don't like this. I think this is a bitch move, personally. Plus, I don't mind a pistol close range. So, personally, Lookout is my thing. It's my go-to. I'll use that with a machine pistol or the 9mm SAP, either one. And then just throw on whatever you want for that. Some people like extended, some high cal, whatever. I use extended. Lookout's really good for snipers, though. It's a very overpowered style basic training. Similar to Rifleman, they're both OP, but I prefer the Lookout strat style. Both are overpowered, though, I will admit, okay? That's the one sniper class you have. And the last class is your long-range rifle. Sometimes you get into rifle gunfights with people that like to head glitch at very large distances. This is a more aggressive mid-range style rifle. It can challenge SMGs, it can challenge LMGs, it can challenge other rifles, especially close range. That's why it has rapid fire on it. If you're getting into long-range head glitchy gunfights, you take the FG. No rapid fire since the FG was unnerfed. You're using Mountain for this one because you're going to be slow moving. You're not going to be pushing up a shitload. And you use Prime to reduce any amount of flinch that you could possibly have. Like I said, this is mainly the head glitch rifle. This is what knocks off all the head glitchers. You don't have to head glitch back all the time. You can, but if it's long range head glitchy gunfights, this is your go-to. Just bread and butter. Right now, the FG is really good after they unnerfed it. And I would go to that pretty much every time if I'm getting into gunfights like that. It's just easier. If you want something that's really good at long range as well, that you if you don't like the FG, oh man, your options are a little limited. I would probably say bar no rapid fire, maybe STG no rapid fire, or a good option alternatively, if you like LMGs, the MG15 is pretty damn dirty. So is the MG42. Low recoil, high damage. They can knock off head glitchers really well. But I'm not sure if you guys like LMGs that much. I kept it to the main primary guns of the game. The four deadly horsemen, as I've mentioned it before, the bar, PPSH, the sniper, and the FG. They still reign supreme. If you want to use them, now you can. Please, for the love of God, only use these classes when you're sweating your real, like just really hardcore sweating your dick off. Like, I don't want to play against this stuff nonstop. I want to help you guys, but I also want to make the game fun. A lot of times you can use this exact same class and just swap out something like an STG, or you can swap it out for that Volk down the bottom of the new Volk. Pretty damn good gun as well. Not bad at all. You can throw on grip. You can throw on, shoot, I don't even know. Reflex sight. You don't need a reflex sight, but you know, you get the point. You can throw anything you want. And this is still a decent class. This is not going to do bad. This will get kills for you. The main thing is you have infantry for strafe speed. You have hunker to survive the grenades. You have a decent gun. You just gotta have the aim with it. You will lose gunfights to the best weapons, but if we can all try to use the best weapons a little bit less, just tone it down, we can have more fun in the game. I hope you guys enjoyed. There you go. If you want to see kill streaks as well, you can see that. I run this in search mainly. I've been using Fire Pilot, but I alternate that with Artillery Barrage. Just depends on the day. Thank you for watching again. Hope this helps. Those are the best five classes you can possibly use in search right now. If you really need to sweat your dick off, go ahead and use them. I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.